Hey guys, welcome back to another ArchDemonGaming video here, bringing you the Space Engineers creation. We're going to be taking a look at the Titan's Waypoint. That's right, the Titan's Waypoint. It is a compact station design I have just created, and it's one that I'm going to be using as a blueprint in-game, most likely. It has been connected. I'm going to be planning on connecting the whole thing with conveyors. I've only connected the reactors to the storage room currently, and as you can see, there is a hangar and there is a docking tube right there. The hangar is rather roomy, but it is only meant for small ships. As you can see, there's two small ships in there right now, but those are for a different video. As you can see, there's point defense, and this is going to be a very defensible base, considering the its size. These ships are going to be done in a different video. They're very fast ships. They're called the Scepter. I'll be doing those in other videos, so check my channel to see if that video is up. It most likely will be by the time this one is. Alright, let's go in and see the ladder room to go up to the next floor. As you can see, it's very cramped. There are 2 point defense turrets here and there. And here's the ladder up to the next floor. Alright, as you can see, there is 6 cargo containers. There are 2 of them that are connected to reactors. The rest are going to go to the refineries in the medical bay. There's point defense around the entire room to protect from invaders. And that's about it for this room. I added a weird, elaborate design on the ceiling there for no apparent reason. This is one of the only stations I've used interior walls, and I don't really use it too much. And as you can see, here is the next room, the reactor room, and it has 4 medical bays and 2 large reactors. I put 2 large reactors in because, well, I mean, whenever you use the refineries in the future and the assemblers in the future, I'm assuming that they're going to require power, and it's going to eat up a lot of powers if you have a lot of refineries and assemblers, and I happen to have a lot of refineries in this space. Alright, and there's point defense around the entire room to protect from invaders. I'm hoping that those will have to be loaded and they'll be automated. I'm hoping you don't have to manually use them. And I'm hoping that in the future you'll be able to input names into those point defense systems, and they won't shoot whoever's name's on the list. Alright, we're done with this room. We're gonna head up top to the next floor, if we can. And this is the refinery and assembler room. As you can see, there's point defense around the entire room. There are 8 assemblers and 6 refineries. A lot of stuff to work with in here. Those refineries, I'm guessing, will be able to... This number of refineries will probably chug out a lot of... suck in a lot of power. Let's go ahead and take a look at the next floor. As you can see, this is the bridge. I did a different design with this bridge than my previous builds. As you can see, the center of the room is built like a spine. There's 4 terminals underneath and 2 terminals above. A little pipe running through the center of the room. There are supply cabinets or containers by each of the bottom terminals. A grav gen in the center. That's the only grav gen inside this entire station. I've been thinking of adding a backup grav gen because it might be a good idea. As you can see, there's point defense on the top as well. And there's an airlock right here to get outside to conduct repairs. And that on top is kind of like an antenna array with a light signal lights. And that's it, guys. Thanks for watching. This has been another ArchDemonGaming video. Subscribe, like, comment. We always like comment and feedback. Check my channel for more videos. We'll be making a lot of videos this coming soon. I'm going to be uploading a crap ton soon after this one. See you next time, guys. Thanks for watching.